Thank you, Mr. President. Mr. President, I come to the floor today as part of Military Appreciation Month. It's a time clearly to remember our brave servicemen and women, to reflect on their faithful service to this country, and to recall the many sacrifices that our troops and their families have made and continue to make in defense of this great nation. Mr. President, many of us will be heading overseas for the 75th anniversary of D-Day to commemorate the efforts of an incredible group of allies on the fateful day and the weeks and the months that followed. As I stand here today, I think of those soldiers and I think of my wife Bobby's dad, Bob Brown, currently 92 years old, living in Thermopolis, Wyoming, longtime postmaster. He still drives Meals on Wheels, Mr. President, as he says, for the old folks. He was called to Europe in World War II. And he's one of those few that was in World War II in the European theater, as well as in Japan as part of that first occupation, and then called back to Korea as part of the 2/300th, who continued in the fight for our freedoms. He continues today to serve our United States and his wife, Jerry, who went through all of this in Thermopolis, Wyoming, knows the sacrifices that he and so many has made. My dad, World War II, Battle of the Bulge. I still carry his dog tags from the Battle of the Bulge with me. I have them with me today on the floor of the Senate, and I carry them with me when I go to see our troops overseas. He's a guy who had to quit school in 9th grade because of the Depression. In World War II, and I've gone through some of his old papers, found pictures of he and a number of members of the artillery who were part of the liberation of France. From the time I was a little boy, he'd say, John, you should thank God every day because you live in America. You don't know how fortunate you are. We are so blessed, Mr. President, to live in this great country. And it is to the men and women who continue to protect this land, who fought for our freedoms, my dad, his wife Louise, the sacrifices that they have made on behalf of all of us. And today, Mr. President, we honor all of our armed forces, the Army, the Navy, the Air Force, the Coast Guard, the Marines, the National Guard. In particular, today, Mr. President, I want to salute the members of the Wyoming Army National Guard, because they are now deploying to the Middle East. Some 300 Wyoming soldiers from 6 units will be sent to the Middle East between January and September, the largest Wyoming deployment in nearly a decade. The deployments began in January with the G Company of the 2nd Battalion, 211th Aviation, a medical evacuation company, the most deployed unit in the Wyoming Guard. The medevac unit, which was sent to Afghanistan, includes Wyoming soldiers from Bear River, from Casper, from Carpenter, from Guernsey, from Cheyenne, and Laramie, and Wheatland. This past week, Wyoming Governor Mark Gordon participated in a send-off ceremony in Casper for 130 Wyoming National Guard troops headed to Texas ahead of a 9-month deployment to the Middle East. And the Wyoming troops from the 2nd Battalion of the 300th Field Artillery, the Cowboy Cannoneers, the group that my father-in-law, Bob Brown, was part of, they are from more than 24 communities, from Casper to Lovell to Cheyenne to Moorcroft. This Guard unit will serve under the U.S. Central Command, covering Iraq, Afghanistan, Kuwait, and the United Arab Emirates. Mr. President, Wyoming and the entire nation owe an incredible debt of gratitude to these fearless fighters for our freedom. So God bless the United States Armed Forces. God bless our troops, our veterans. God bless the United States of America. Mr. President, I yield the floor.